John Rhys-Davies is one of the most outstanding actors of his generation, hugely experienced on both stage and screen. He's perhaps best known for his portrayal of Gimli the Dwarf in Peter Jackson's Lord of the Rings. When we were looking for a central storyteller for this film, a friend told me of John's personal enthusiasm for the King James Bible. It made our choice very easy. John's genuine passion and interest drives this film forward in a very powerful way. After it was all over, I wanted to find out what he'd made of it. This is what he said.
King James Bible is special because the people who assembled it, determined that it should be written, were special. It's a special Bible, written at a special time. A time when the language was actually molten, when the language could have gone any way, they shaped it thus. Part of the Protestant Reformation is a need for words, is a need for great sermons, is a need for instruction, is a need for moral debate as much as it is entertainment. They don't want these puny 13-minute homilies. They want 4 hours of scholarship, difficult reasoning. They want the assurance that there is a way from this mire of earth to the certainty of heaven. How do we navigate? How do we negotiate our way there? Tell us, O curer of our souls. And they get it in these wonderful sermons of John Donne. They get it, and the rationale for it is salvation. But it comes through the negotiations that these clever translators give, the uncompromising search for meaning and the certainty of translation, the certainty of understanding. But it has to be understood by all. It has to be broadcast from the ministry. It has to be in simple, clear, resonant words. And that's what gives the James Version its special character. To those who seek, they shall find. To those that knock, the door shall be opened unto them. Of course, this is a great secular age. This is and secularism has its virtues as well as its pitfalls. But in a way, all of us have to ask, Lord, what must I do to gain eternal life? Begging a lot of questions there. But the uncompromising answer, which all of us have to gulp at when we hear it, is give up all and follow me. Oof. Or can't I just have a little bit of... is there a bit of wriggle room there? No.
I think you're turning into a preacher.
Who am I? Where am I going to? Where do I come from? These are the eternal questions. And to be honest with you, having had a look at the world's religions, the one that offers most liberation, the one that offers the most the optimal range for the human spirit is the message of Christianity, is that Judeo-Christian tradition that has incorporated the individual, the right of the individual to think his own thoughts, the freedom of conscience, equality before the law, as indeed we are all equal before God. I know I'm begging questions to the secular amongst us, amongst whom I'm not sure that I am not counted. But all those great things, those virtues, secularism, the division of church and state, the separation of church and state, the right of real equality, the abolition of slavery, the abolition of slavery is one of the great triumphs of Christianity. No other civilization attempted it. No other civilization achieved it. It was bought with blood and intellectual passion, but it is born of Christianity, nothing else. Well, of course the Bible is relevant today. Good Lord, I mean, are we going to dismiss Magna Carta? Are we going to dismiss the Bill of Rights because they're not relevant? How people interact with God, with society, with nature, with the law, with custom, degree, priority, and place, insisture, course, proportion, season, form, office, and custom, as Shakespeare would put it. Well, it's the best entertainment you'll have for the next hour and a half. It's entertaining, it's illuminating, and it gets back to burnishing, taking the dust off that extraordinary, book, the Bible. The James Version was intended to be a unifying translation that gets rid of the grime between the confusions of earlier translation. What did God say? What does the Bible say? What did Christ say? How can we get close to that? Inadvertently, it becomes actually the standard by which other translations are dealt with. Do we need modern translations? You bet. Yep. If you want to know what the closest we can possibly get, yes, there will always be a need for fresh translations. But the standard by which we gauge them is the James Bible. And in itself, it is the sound of the living God. Am I a Christian? Oh, not good enough. I can't quite give up all to follow him yet. Lord, I believe, help thou mine unbelief. But that said, it's like the American Constitution itself, isn't it? It's the best darn draft at the way we should organize our lives that I know of. For me, this film has been a delight because it examines a piece of history that I thought I rather knew and throws, for instance, James up in a more generous light than most people give him. I thought I sort of knew James, but this is a new James. This is a very exciting time, as the time of James was. This is a time when doubts and troubles and examinations, uncertainties, really abound. And that's really the best of times for where you have moral examination. Those are glorious times. They are troubling times. It is a difficult time to be alive. It is also the best of times to be alive. In the end, we have to examine, we have to find some sort of moral compass to live by. And I think it is probably, to use those old expressions, for me and my house, I will serve the Lord.
Damn it.
With some difficulty.